Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning, and I'm at Little Strawberry Lake, high in the Strawberry Wilderness in eastern Oregon. The Strawberry Mountains begin their story about 17 million years ago, when crustal melting produced by the Yellowstone hotspot produced the Strawberry Volcanics, an enormous suite of andesite lavas primarily. But that's not what I'm here to look for. Up here at Strawberry Lake, I'm surrounded by colossal 1,000-foot-high cliffs and a beautiful crystal-clear lake. This is the seat of the last glacier to have filled this valley. During the last ice age, and as well as earlier glacial periods, many of the large gorges in the Strawberry Mountains were filled with glacial ice. At this location, glacial ice would have been nearly 1,000 feet deep. And as that glacial ice advanced and retreated, it left behind glacial deposits. If you've been watching my series documenting my earthquake research in the area, you know all about these glacial moraines and how they're important for dating the age of the most recent earthquake on the Strawberry Mountains fault. However, at Little Strawberry Lake, the lake itself is impounded by a glacial moraine. This formation here, this landform, is called a cirque, C-I-R-Q-U-E. And a cirque is the last sort of holdout of a glacier before it completely melts away. So about 10,300 years ago, I'm estimating that based on other locations around in Oregon that have these similar features, the glacier that once filled the Strawberry Canyon, Strawberry Basin, had retreated to just this last area, and it carved out a little bowl which is now held by Strawberry Lake, and it's impounded by a small moraine. This small moraine has been breached, and Little Strawberry Lake pours over it in a lovely little stream, and we've left behind this colossal amphitheater behind me. This area is really strikingly beautiful and allows us to see the interior of a volcanic complex in a way many other places don't allow. So Little Strawberry Lake is formed directly by glacial action, and that is in contrast to Strawberry Lake further down the trail by the parking lot, which was actually dammed by a colossal landslide. The landslide that impounds Strawberry Lake revealed an enormous section of beautiful red volcanic rock, as well as other colors that indicate different volcanic compositions and eruption styles. Overall, the Strawberry Wilderness is filled with wonderful and interesting features, both volcanologically and glaciologically. I'm very fortunate to be able to do my master's degree research in this area, and it really is one of the scenic treasures of Oregon. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you very much for watching.